Good afternoon and welcome to Williams Dog Training Company. We're here today with Fred and Lana, and what we're going to be demonstrating for you today is Lana's ability to understand and respond to her obedience commands, the corrections and motivations we give her while we are working with her, and the training equipment that we're using. Fred is using a regular 6-foot web training leash, and he's going to keep the bulk of that leash folded neatly in his right hand, leaving his left hand free to give the correction. The correction that we give is a tug and let go to the training collar, which is the second piece of equipment that we're using. Lana's been fitted with her own personal training collar, and we'll show you how to properly use this during your one-on-one lesson. As you can see, Lana is seated nicely on Fred's left, which is where all our obedience training is done. The first command they'll demonstrate is heeling, which is proper walking on a leash, and Fred and Lana take off doing that now. The command you want to use for this is Lana heel, and then you just start walking and she'll fall right in line on your left-hand side. And we've also gone ahead and incorporated our sit command into this, so anytime Fred stops his feet, as he just did, Lana sits. It's important when you're heeling Lana that she walks nicely at your pace on your left-hand side. She shouldn't try to pull ahead or lag behind. If she did attempt to pull ahead or lag behind, you say no, give a tug and let go correction to the training collar, repeat your command to heel, and then start walking again. Now next we're going to be showing you our stay command, which is a hand and voice command. Fred's going to use the open flat of his left palm an inch or so from Lana's muzzle and the one word command to stay. He then walks out to the end of the training leash. This is a great exercise to build up self-control and maturity in Lana. You want to start practicing this command at about a minute and work your way up in increments to about 3. Now as Fred returns back to Lana, he's going to walk all the way around her, providing an added distraction as he goes behind her, and right back to that left-hand side heel position. She holds her sit-stay throughout, and he gives her a little praise, and then he heels her right out of it. We'll show you a little more of the heel sit and stay. There's that automatic sit.
Stay.
And gives her the stay again. Back out to the end of that training leash. This time, instead of returning back, he demonstrates the come or recall command. You call her in using her name and a nice voice. She comes and sits in front. Then we have an exercise called the finish. Fred heels her right around the back of him, gets her right back on his left-hand side heel position, and she sits.
Stay.
He's going to demonstrate it one more time. Has her in a sit, gives her the stay, out to the end of the training leash. Calls her into him. She comes in, sits in front, and then the finish. He heels her right around the back of him and gets her right back to his left-hand side heel position, and she sits. Nicely done. It's a good time to remind you, you want to practice all your commands with Lana about 15 to 20 minutes a day. You can practice inside or outside your home, and just incorporate the commands into your daily routine with her. It helps to keep the commands fresh in her mind, and you can see she doesn't mind doing them as her tail's wagging the whole time. Next, we'll show you our down commands. The first is down from a heel position. Fred will use the open flat of his left palm straight down to the ground and the one word firm command to down.
No, down.
And to give her a little correction there. So we show you how you give a slight tug and let go correction and you repeat your command. He then put her in the stay and walked out to the end of the leash. It's another great exercise to build up that self-control and maturity in Lana. You can start practicing this command at 3 minutes and work your way up to about 5. As he returns back to her, he's going to walk all the way around her, just like he did on the sit stay, and right back to that left-hand side heel position. She holds her down stay throughout, and he heels her right out of it. We'll show you that down command one more time when they come back around. And you see, it's very important to always follow through with your command. So if you give Lana a command and she does not obey, the first word out of your mouth is no, followed by a tug and let go correction, and then you're going to repeat your command. Now he gives her the down again, and a stay, and back out to the end of his training leash. This time he'll demonstrate that come and recall command right out of the down position. Calls her in using her name. He's going to have her sit when she gets in front of him. And then he's going to heel her right around the back of him and gets her right back to his left-hand side heel position, and she sits. We'll give them a second to get lined up for a down from a distance command. This will be down from a distance. You're going to have her in a sit, give her a stay, walk out to the end of your leash. This is the only time you're going to use your right hand to give the command, and Fred will drop her into a down from the end of the training leash.
No, down. No.
And then he returns back to her, walking all the way around. And right back to that left-hand side heel position.
Heel.
Heels are right out of it. And those are our basic commands we've worked on with Lana here at school. He's also going to show you a little bit of advanced stuff that we've just started with her. We don't intend for you to do this immediately when you first start working with her, but this will show you what you can build up to with her as long as you put in your 15 to 20 minutes a day and work with her. So we put her in a sit, gave her a stay, dropped the leash completely, then walks the perimeter of the building. She holds that stay throughout.
Down.
And then he comes back and he's going to give her a down. And another stay. And back away from her again. Still completely off leash. And he's going to walk all the way around the building again while she holds that down stay. Again, this just shows you what you can build up to with Lana as she grows and matures. We don't want you to start doing her commands off leash immediately. Work with her 15 to 20 minutes a day. Practice your commands on leash. And as she matures and you have her completely working perfectly for you, you can start to build up the off leash with her. All right, we've shown you all our obedience commands we've worked on with Lana here at school. It's been a pleasure working with Lana, and we thank you again for choosing Williams Dog Training Company as your personal dog trainer.